given to C.
One byte of memory is reserved for that particular C variable. So how you are going to represent that one? So this one is nothing but the block. Okay. And this, the name for this particular block is nothing but the C. Okay. Assume that, guys, suppose if you want to store multiple variables, just like integer A, if you have been used one more B and C. And during runtime, suppose if you want to store, okay, I will initialize this variable as a 10. And what will happen, guys, if suppose during runtime, I will update the value for that I as a 20, sorry, A as a 20. Is this possible to again access the value for A as a 10? Is this possible to recover that value which is already available for that particular A variable? Yes, is this possible?
No, sir.
No, because with respect to integer A, only one memory block is available and we are going to update that particular memory. Okay. So whenever we are using that particular A variable, so means what? We are going to update that block continuously when we are going to initialize the same memory block. Okay. But instead of array, if we are using the array data structure, yes, what will happen, guys, here in this case of array? Yes, can anyone tell me why we are using array? Array is used to store
collection of similar
type of data.
Okay, array is nothing but the collection of similar type of data. Okay, array is nothing but the collection of similar type of data. Means what? If you are going to declare this array as a, okay, this is the syntax. What is the syntax for array declaration, guys? This is the syntax. First of all, we require the data type. In which data or in which type you want to store all the values inside the memory? So first of all, the data type, then name for that particular data, then open the square bracket, and inside that provide its size. So this is the syntax in which you are going to represent that array. Okay, so this is the example, integer A and 5 and semicolon. Means what? Inside the memory, 5 different blocks are reserved. Okay, so this one is nothing but the memory. And inside this memory, this is the first block, this is the second block, this is the third block, this is the fourth one, last one is the fifth one. So 5 different blocks are reserved with the help of this array. And what is the name for this particular array? Yes, guys, the name for this particular array is nothing but A. Okay, A. And you are going to access all these blocks individually one by one, because whenever you are going to initialize any array, by default indexing is available with respect to each and every array. So with respect to this array, by default indexing always start with
zero.
So zero. First block is nothing but the zero. Okay, I will write all the indexes here. So first one is nothing but zero, next index is 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, so these are nothing but indices with respect to that array. Okay, so you can easily access either this first block, this second one, this fourth one, as per your choice, because with respect to all these blocks indices is available. And if you want to store multiple values with respect to this block, you can store. But the basic condition with respect to this array is that you are going to store only similar type of data. So here in this case, we are going to store only which type of data, guys? Yes, only integer type of data. Okay, because we have declared that particular array is of integer type. Okay, 40 and 50. Yes, guys, why we are going to store only integer type of data? Because when we have created that particular array, integer a of 5, so the type of that particular array is nothing but integer. So this particular array or this particular, these are the different blocks which are going to accept only integer type of data. Okay, guys, if you are using float, if you are using the float, another representation, float a as a, okay, float b as a 6. Okay, float b as a 6. So how many blocks are reserved? 6 different blocks are reserved for which data type? For float data type. Okay, guys, clear about this array? How you are going to initialize that particular array? Yes, guys, up to initialization. Yes, clear.
Yes sir.
Up to this, if you have any doubt with respect to this array, just ask me, because now we are moving toward next one. How we are going to initialize this particular array with respect to their values, then how we are going to access different variables with respect to this array. Yes, guys, up to this initialization, is there any doubt? If no doubt,
no sir.
Okay, this is the first syntax in which you are going to just declare that particular array or block. Then how you are going to initialize that particular array? This is the another way. Suppose integer a of 5, and then use the curly bracket to use or to represent the array. This is the another way. Yes, with the help of curly bracket, we are going to provide the values with respect to all these blocks. Initially, we have provided the blank, okay, blank curly bracket. So for each and every block, 0 is available or empty block is available. Next, if you want to provide the values with respect to all these blocks, yes, how you are going to provide the values? This is the representation, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 and semicolon. So in this manner also, you are going to initialize that particular array. Okay, guys, yes, clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So this is the first syntax. This is the first one. Just if you want to declare that array, integer a of 5 without values. Second one, this is the another way, integer a of 5 with the help of empty brackets, curly brackets. This is the another way, integer a of 5 is equal to, then provide the values. Not necessary to provide all the 5 values. Okay, during runtime, if you have only 2 different values, and if you have and you have reserved 3 different blocks during runtime, or during runtime reserve, during runtime initialization, it is also possible. Means what? Is this also possible? Integer a of 5, and you are going to just provide 10, 20. Yes, is this possible, guys? 10, 20. Yes, guys, is this possible declaration, integer a of 5, but we are just using 2 different blocks, 10, 20. Yes, is this possible? Guys, I'm waiting for your reply. Is this possible? Yes, because
yes,
we are going to create different blocks. How many blocks? We are using 5 different blocks. Okay, so this is the first block, second block, third one, fourth one, and fifth one. And we are going to initialize only 2 different blocks with respect to 2 different values, 10 and 20. So 3 different blocks are again empty, and we are going to initialize all these blocks during runtime. Is this possible? Okay, with respect to this array. Up to this, guys, clear? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And suppose if you want to access any variable. Okay, suppose just try to consider, guys. Suppose this is our array, integer a of 5. And we have given 5 different values, 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50. And suppose my question is that I want to access, guys, listen carefully. I want to access this particular variable, 30, or I want to access this value. Is this possible to directly access that value from array?
Yes, sir.
Yes, possible, because for each and every block, we have they are internally compiler have provided the indices So 30 is available at which index? At the 2 index. So how you are going to access that particular value? Yes, directly a of 2. And suppose you are using one more variable, a integer a is equal to b, and you are going to initialize it to b variable. What is meant by this guy's declaration? Integer b is equal to a of 2 means what?
Okay, means the value of stored at 2 second index is
okay, accessing value means what? A is nothing but the array, and from that array we are going to access which block? Second number block. But by default array index always start with 0, so let us start with 0 first of all. 0, then 1 and 2. Now compiler move towards this particular position, and from that particular position he will accept this 30 value and it initialize to this particular b variable. Okay, in this manner we are going to accessing all the values from that particular array. Okay guys, clear?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Okay, I will show you this simple example, simple demonstration. Whatever the task which we have been done, I will show you. Okay, this is related with array. Array. For that, I will save this whiteboard. Okay, I will share that whiteboard. Whatever the we have written on that whiteboard. So just go through that. Yes. What is the syntax for declaration with respect to array? First of all, data type. Then the name of that particular array, a. Open square bracket and close square bracket. So this is the way in which we are going to declare that particular array. So inside this we have to provide the size. Okay, next one. This is the one way. Another way, directly initialize all the values 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. And suppose I want to assign any value. Yes, suppose initialize that b variable with the help of 30 value. So what is the position for 30 guys? Yes, position for 30, 0, 1 and 2. So 30 is available at second position with respect to this array. So initialize that b variable. Yes, how you are going to initialize? We are going to accept that 30 by using index, and we are providing index for which array? For a array. So a of 2 semicolon. Now just print the value of that c out. I'll show you the output. What is happening? Okay, connection reestablish. Before that, I will copy this code. Once again, I will compile. Okay, bicycles. Verify.